हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडाइनेमिक्स। सो फर्स्ट थियरी इज एनर्जी ए प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द सिस्टम। नाउ यू वांट टू डिराइव एनी थिंग इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द सिस्टम, देन यू हैव टू प्रूव दैट इट इज पॉइंट फंक्शन। ओके, if you prove that it is point function, then it is the property of the system. So here energy a property of the system, so we have to prove that energy is the point function, means energy which can be located by a point on the graph, then it is known as a point function. So consider a system which is change its state 1 to 2 following the path a. You can see that there is one PV diagram is given. On this PV diagram, process 1 to 2 is taking place to a path A. Okay, and the process is returning at its initial state, means process 2 to 1 through a path B as well as path C. When cycle is taking place 1A2B1, then QA is equal to delta EA plus WA as per the first law. Undergoing to a cycle, we know that Q sigma Q is equal to J into sigma W. Okay, so we can apply this rule. If process is taking place in a cycle, so QA is equal to delta EA plus WA, and QB is equal to delta EB plus WB. When we apply this rule, sigma W cycle is equal to sigma Q cycle into J. J is considering as a one, as a constant. Okay, so WA plus WB is equal to QA plus QB. So QA minus WA is equal to WB minus QB. So delta EA is equal to minus delta EB. Why? Because Q minus W, that means delta E. Okay, rate of change of internal energy. So QA minus WA is equal to delta E A. And here on right hand side, we are taking minus outside from the system. So QB minus WB is delta EB. So delta EA is equal to minus delta EB. Okay, so this is the equation for process 1A2BA cycle. Okay, now second cycle process 1A2C1. Okay, for that we are writing the equation similar to above process. Then we are getting same equation, delta EA is equal to minus delta EC. Okay, QA is the same, delta EA plus WA. QC is equal to delta EC plus WC. When we apply the Joule's principle, sigma W cycle is equal to sigma Q cycle, then WA plus WC is equal to QA plus QC. Instead of B, we have to use C. Then QA minus WA is equal to WC minus QC. So it is delta EA is equal to minus delta EC. So we can write that left hand side of both the equations are same. So right hand side are also same. So delta minus delta EB is equal to minus delta EC. So delta EB is equal to delta EC. Okay. So we can see that when we change the path, means first cycle 1A2B1 and second cycle 1A2C1, both having a same amount of change of internal energy, delta EB is equal to delta EC, means this rate of change of internal energy, which is not depending on a path, it is depending only the point. Means I already tell you that if we have to prove any quantity as a property of the system, then we have to prove that it is the point function. Okay, so from this equation, delta EB is equal to delta EC, which is indicating us that rate of change of internal energy, which is not depending on a path, we change path B and C both the time, we are getting same amount of rate of change of internal energy, means it is the point function, it is not depending on a path, so it is the property of the system. And there is one statement is also given here, therefore it is seen that the change in energy between two state of the system is same whatever the path the system may follow in undergoing the change of the state. So if some arbitrary value of energy is assigned to the state 2, the value of energy at state 1 is fixed independent of the path the system follows. Therefore energy has a definite value for every state of the system, hence it is the point function and the property of the system that I already explained you. The energy E is extensive property, the specific energy small e means energy per unit mass capital E by M is intensive property. Now we already discussed about intensive and extensive property. Intensive property means independent of the extensive property is the depending on the mass. So internal energy capital E or energy of capital E is the extensive property of the system. But if we are taking specific internal energy means energy per unit mass, then it is intensive property. Okay, now we are discussing about energy of an isolated system or internal energy of the isolated system, both are the same. So an isolated system is one in which there is no interaction of the system with the surrounding for isolation system, means we already know that open system, closed system and isolated system. In open system we know that heat and work both transfer are possible. Okay, in closed system heat and work, sorry, in closed system mass as well as energy both transfer is possible. In closed system only energy transfer is possible, and in isolated system there is no mass, there is no energy transfer is possible, means there is no interaction of the system with the surrounding in form of energy, in form of mass. Okay, so there is no energy transfer means there is no heat transfer, there is no work transfer. So if we write Q is equal to delta E plus W, or in differential form delta Q is equal to dE plus dW, then we know that dQ is equal to 0 and dW is also 0, because both is not possible for the isolated system. So dE is equal to 0. When we taking integration on both the side, then integration of dE is equal to capital E, and integration of 0 is the constant, so E is the constant. So energy is remains constant, or internal energy of the isolated system is remains constant. Okay, this is the one of the conclusion of this derivation. And if we are considering any isolated system, then we have to keep my we have to consider that internal energy of that system is remains constant. Now we are discussing about internal energy or energy of the system. Q is equal to delta E plus W. When we write in differential form, then delta Q is equal to delta W plus delta E. For reversible non-flow process, delta W is equal to P dV. Now it is very important for us, reversible and non-flow process. Okay, non-flow process means there is no flow. Okay, flow means you understand that it is applicable for the closed system. In open system, flow is possible. In closed system, non-flow process is possible because there is no mass transportation. Okay, so for that closed system, you know that work done on the system is equal to P into delta V. Okay, so it is right in form of P dV plus delta E. The energy E includes all form of energy in the system. Means all form means kinetic energy, potential energy, internal energy, chemical energy, electrical energy, all types of energy which included capital E. Okay, but we are discussing about non-flow and reversible process. Non-flow process is only possible in the closed system, means there is no mass transfer is taking place from system to surrounding or surrounding to system. Okay, that's why here I am writing delta W is equal to P dV. Okay, so this internal energy, capital E energy of the system, which is including internal energy, kinetic energy, potential energy, chemical energy plus electrical energy. Okay, now for the closed system, there is no flow of the fluid into or out of the system, so kinetic energy is not considered. We know that in a closed system there is no mass flow rate or there is no mass transfer is taking place. That's why kinetic energy is becoming zero. Same thing for the potential energy. Potential energy, we know that it is the energy due to the storage the fluid at a height or storage the system at a certain height. So we know that for the closed system it is also zero. Then chemical energy, we know that there is no chemical process is taking place in a closed system, or we can say that there is no change in a molecular structure of the material in a closed system. That's why we can consider chemical energy is equal to zero, and electrical energy is also considered as a zero. Okay, because electrical energy is due to the transfer of valence or free electron from the system, and here we know that in closed system there is no transfer of molecules from system to surrounding or surrounding to system or between two system. That's why electrical energy is also considered as a zero. So energy of the system is equal to internal energy, which is indicating by U. Okay, so E is equal to U here. Okay, so first law of thermodynamics, in form of differential, delta Q is equal to delta W plus du. Okay, capital Q means total heat, capital W means total work, and capital U means total internal energy. If we are considering specific heat, specific work, then we are getting specific internal energy. Okay, so internal energy capital U associate with the molecular motion and is stored in molecules and atomic structure of the substance. I already explained you that internal energy of the system or energy of the system is energy stored inside the system due to its molecular structure. Okay, it is known as the internal energy. Now for ideal gas, there is no molecular force of attraction and repulsion. Therefore, internal energy depending only on the temperature. Now we know that in a solid and liquid phase, molecules are very nearer to the each other, so there are very high chance of attraction or repulsion. But in gaseous fluid, we know that molecules are very far away from each other, so there is no chance of attraction and repulsion. That's why internal energy of that gaseous fluid is depending only on the absolute temperature. So small u means specific internal energy of the gas is the function of the absolute temperature, capital T. Now we are discussing about enthalpy. Now you already studied the definition of enthalpy in 11th and 12th sense also. as well as in basics mechanical engineering subject. Okay, so in enthalpy is the summation of internal energy plus work done. Okay, so here there is one statement is given: while analyzing process, we frequently come across certain combination of property. For sake of simplicity and convenience, this combination is defined as a new thermodynamic property. The enthalpy is the combination of two property as internal energy and product of pressure and volume. We know that pressure and volume product is also known as a work done. Okay, so H small h is equal to U plus P into V. Now here small h, that means specific enthalpy. Specific enthalpy means enthalpy per unit mass is equal to small u, that means specific internal energy, means internal energy per unit mass, plus pressure P into specific volume, means volume per unit mass. Okay, so small h is equal to small u plus P into V. Since u, P, V are all properties, therefore h also a property. Okay, now you already know that internal energy is the property of the system. We already prove in starting of this lecture, as well as pressure and specific volume is also property of the system. So enthalpy is also the property of the system. Okay, so it is the intensive property of the system because H is specific enthalpy kilojoule per kg. I already explained that small h, that means specific enthalpy. Total enthalpy is denoted by capital H, and total enthalpy is depending on the mass, and it is extensive property. But when we discussing about specific enthalpy, then it is intensive property. Okay, now here above equation will multiply with the mass. M into H is equal to M into U plus M into P into V. So it is converted, capital H is equal to U plus P into capital V. Here H is the enthalpy and extensive property like U and V. Okay, I already discussed with you. Enthalpy of constant pressure process. Okay, now above equation, capital H is equal to small u plus P into small V. Okay, it is in form of differential form. Okay, we know that heat is equal to, for constant pressure process, delta Q is equal to du plus P dV. Okay, as per our first law of thermodynamics, Q is equal to u plus delta, sorry, Q is equal to W plus delta E. Instead of E, we can replace E with U. So it is becoming Q is equal to W plus delta U. Okay, so the Q is equal to DU plus PdV, because constant pressure work done equation is PdV. So dQ is equal to dU plus PdV. Now for constant pressure, PdV is equal to differentiation of P into V. So dQ is equal to dU plus differentiation of P into V. So dQ is equal to differentiation of U plus PV. You can also write that equation in, because both the in form of differentiation. So dQ is equal to differentiation of U plus PV. So dQ is equal to dH. What is the meaning of it? For constant pressure process, rate of change of heat is equal to rate of change of enthalpy. Please remember this word. Rate of change of heat is equal to rate of change of enthalpy. Now for the constant volume process, dQ is equal to dU plus PdV. Now for constant volume process, there is no change in the work. Sorry, there is no change in the volume. That's why P into dV is becoming zero. So dq is equal to du. So we can say that for constant volume process, rate of change of heat is equal to rate of change of internal energy. The enthalpy of ideal gas is depending on the temperature. So H is the function of the temperature for the ideal gases. Okay, same as per the internal energy, enthalpy is also function of the temperature for the ideal gases. Now we are discussing about perpetual motion of first kind, PMM1. Now what is the meaning of perpetual motion machine? Perpetual motion machine means any machine which violates the statement of the law, it is known as a perpetual motion machine. Here perpetual motion machine for the first kind, PMM1, means it is the machine which is the violate the statement of the first law of thermodynamics. Okay, so here there is one definition is given: any device that violates either the law is called perpetual motion machine. A device that violates the first law of thermodynamics called a perpetual motion machine of the first kind, a PMM1. I already explained you that any machine which violates the statement of the law, which is known as a perpetual motion machine. And here this machine is violating the statement of the first law, then it is known as a first law of perpetual motion machine of first kind. Okay, now here there are two diagrams are given. Okay, first a PMM1, second one is the converse of PMM1. So here one dotted line is indicating Q and one straight line which is indicating W. So Q is in form of dotted line, means what is the meaning of it? Please understand, we are not supplying the heat to the system and we are getting work in the output of the system or engine continuously, means it is never be possible. We already know that when we supply the heat to the engine, we are getting work in the output of the engine. Okay, so it is violating the statement of the first law, so it is known as a perpetual motion machine of the first kind or PMM1. Same thing, converse of the PMM1 means opposite of it. Here we are continuously supply the work to the machine, but we are not getting heat at the output of the machine, means it is also not possible. When we supply the heat, then we are getting the work. When we supply the work, we are getting the heat. Okay, but here in first engine, we are not supplying the heat and we are getting continuously work in the output. In second, the converse of PMM1, we are continuously supplying the work, but we are not getting the heat at the output. That's why this both the system which is violating the statement of the first law, it is known as a perpetual motion machine of the first kind and converse of the perpetual motion of the first kind. As shown in the figure, the machine or system continuously produces the mechanical work without receiving the energy, which violates the first law of the thermodynamics. State the general principle of energy as energy is neither be created nor be destroyed, but only gets transferred from one form to the another form. And the converse of PMM1, as shown in the figure, a machine which would continuously consume the work without producing the any work, without producing any form of energy. This is also the violate the first law of the thermodynamics. So this is PMM1. So today we stop lecture here. In next lecture, we are discussing about types of flow processes and steady flow processes and application of steady flow processes.